Before I place my views on this bill, I would like to remind this august house that All India Trinamool Congress strongly believes that bill must be scrutinized by standing committee before they are passed. This is a good way to improve legislation and not rush with them. This was one of the few bills to be scrutinized by standing committee and we welcome it. Sir, there are around 5 lakhs transgender people in our country. However, the transgender community in India is one of the most marginalized communities because they do not fit the stereotypical category, men or women. Transgender have faced discrimination, ostracism, hates, crimes, detestation, harassment, abuse, animosity, and lack of opportunity in almost all spheres of life for centuries in India, a traditionally conservative country. Sir, they have always been considered far from equal to other two genders in a country whose constitution is based on facets such as equality, liberty, justice and fraternity. On the very onset, this bill falls short of the human rights obligation. The haste at which the bill was passed in Lok Sabha is clearly evident. The bill is unclear on a transgender person's right to self-identity, which is the basic purpose for which the bill is supposed to have been conceived. Sir, the Transgender Persons Bill lay out a broad and inclusive definition of transgender persons and a clear distinction between identity-based recognition rights and the medical procedures some transgender people might want. Sir, I would like to say the bill says that a transgender person shall have a right to self-perceived gender identity. Its language could be interpreted to mean transgender people are required to have certain surgeries before legally changing their gender. Sir, this bill clearly fails on the fundamental rights to self-identity as laid down by the Supreme Court. I would like to urge the Honorable Minister that it's crucial that the law be in line with the Supreme Court's historic ruling on transgender's right. Sir, this bill to protect the right of transgender people would not provide full protection and recognition. It is important to mention the work done by the West Bengal government under Mamata Banerjee in this area. Bengal was the first state in the country to set up the Transgender Development Board. It is distributing identification cards to all the members of transgender community, which will take care of education, health, employment-related issues. Manavi Bandhupadhyay, India's first transgender college principal, has been made vice chairman of the board. The board has initiated the employment of transgender persons into the volunteer civic police and has also started building separate toilets or modifying existing one for transgender students at all state-run and state-aided colleges. Sir, in Chapter 3, which deals with recognition of identity of transgender person, as I see, the bill appears to mandate a two-step process for legal gender recognition. First, it requires a transgender person to apply for a transgender certificate. This can be done on the basis of a person's self-declared identity. Then a certificate holder can apply for a change in gender certificate, which signals to authorities to change their legal gender to male or female. This second step appeared to require surgery and then documentation by a medical authority confirming it. Sir, the bill empowers the district magistrate to judge the correctness of the application and decide whether to issue the change in gender certificate, but does not give the guidelines on how the decision should be made. Sir, another Chapter 4, welfare measures by the government, The transgender people in India should be able to live with dignity and non-discrimination and have equal access to education, employment and health service. To enact a law that meets international standard, it's critical that Parliament fully bring transgender people into the conversation. The Supreme Court in Nalsa versus India ruled that transgender people should be recognized as a third gender and enjoy all the fundamental rights while also being entitled to specific benefit in education and employment. In 2018, in a historic decision upholding privacy and non-discrimination of LGBT persons, the Supreme Court struck down the colonial-era sodomy law that criminalized consensual same-sex relation. Sir, in this bill, penal provision for sexual assault against a transgender person is imprisonment for a period of minimum 6 months and maximum 2 years only, whereas for other sexual assault is punishable by imprisonment not less than 7 years and maximum of life imprisonment. Honorable Minister, this is probably the biggest flaw with the bill is in its present form. It clearly encourages the rape and sexual assault of the transgender persons. Sir, bill should properly enlist the right of transgender person to marry, adopt and inherit property. Sir, since the transgender are basically unemployed and without a definitive regular income, the bill should provide free sex reassignment, surgeries, hormonal therapy, laser therapy or any other health treatment for transgender in both public and private hospitals. The bill should include setting up of national and state transgender commission on the lines of women commission. The ultimate goal of this bill is to provide gender identity, the creation of third gender. We have to create separate, create space for said gender, not accommodate them within first and second gender. As according to the landmark of Nalsa judgment, when the third gender comes into being, we have to provide facility of all kinds of socio-economic, etc., as provided to the other two genders. Sir, Lok Sabha, known as the House of People, can now be called the House of Hest. But we are the House of Elders. We have to act sensibly. After all, we are the House of Maturity and Sensibility. This half-baked bill, if becomes a law, will surely chaotic on ground. Our already overburdened judiciary will be flooded with avoidable litigation. I would like to remind the Honorable Minister that transgender person is born in every religion, in every caste and every language, every community around the world. Hence, this bill can safely be stated as mega bill, which will have for reaching consequence in the lives of the other two gender. Hence, refer the bill to a select committee at this state. I would like the Honorable Minister to clear my doubts. Thank you, sir.